Help! My Shopify store is not showing up on Google. What can I do? Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more customers and more sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to get your Shopify store on Google search. There's a one tool that you need to set up, which is the Google Search Console. Previously, Google Search Console is also known as the Google Webmasters tool. By getting this tool set up for your Shopify store, you can tell Google that your Shopify store exists and you have these products and all these pages, and Google will put it into the storage. And when a shopper or browser goes on Google search to search for products that could be yours, then Google will decide to show it on Google search results. If you don't have this Google Search Console set up, basically you're waiting around for Google search algorithm to scan the entire web. So there are hundreds and thousands of Shopify stores and other websites going live on the internet every day. Google doesn't have the resources and capacities to scan every single website and or every single store. So if you have a Shopify store or WooCommerce store and you are relatively new and nobody's really coming to your website, you're just sitting there waiting for Google to know about you, then you'll never appear on Google search. If you want to be found on Google search, you need to set this tool up, Google Search Console. You need to verify that that's your store, that's your website. And what you need to do as well is to submit a sitemap, what your website is about, what are the pages that you have, what product pages that you have. You submit it on this tool and then Google will process this information. Then they will know over on their side, on their system, they will know that, oh yes, there's this store that's right here. So the next time if someone is searching about the products that your store offers, then they can show them your product pages. Otherwise, it's never really going to show up. How do you set up Google Search Console then? Shortly, I'm going to show a screen share on my computer where I'm going to show you how you can sign up for this account and how can you verify it. And once you have this account set up, what information or how can you navigate around Google Search Console so Google will have the correct information for your website. So let's head on to my computer. Let's go.
Right now, we are in front of my computer. Go to Google and type Google Search Console. And this is the results you will see here. Click on this first results over here. Click on this. After you click on that result, you will come right here. This is the Google Search Console homepage. And you can click on Start Now. This button over here that says Start Now. And it will bring you to a Gmail sign-in, a Google sign-in. Say sign-in to continue to Google Search Console. So if you have an existing Gmail account or if your Business Suite account is from Google, type that in. If you don't have, then you might want to create an account before you come back here. Log in with this email, type in your email address, and then you click on Next over here. The blue button. Then it will bring you to the next page of logged in, which is to enter your password and click on next. And this will bring you to the Google Search Console. So this is the reporting interface. If you have everything set up, every time you want to check on your Google search status, on which pages have been indexed or which pages are getting you clicks from Google, this will be where you will be directed to. So right now, if you don't have any account set up for your Shopify store, so this will be empty, and you need to click on over here under Search Console. You will click on the down arrow button and this will show up, add property. So click on that. Then this dialog box will pop up. So you will have this adding property type domain as well as a URL prefix. So for your Shopify store, you can just type in your Shopify email address. So anything that starts with www or m.yoururl.com, anything that has HTTPS or HTTP, you can add in right here. So you can type it in. You don't have to add the www, you just have anything after www. You don't have to enter HTTPS as well. So you just type in like what it says over here, example.com. So you can just put in your URL, something.com or .co.uk, whatever. So once you enter that, then you will be able to click on continue. In this case, the continue button will be enabled. It'll turn gray so you can continue. And this dialog box will show up to say verifying the property that you are setting up. Once that's verified, then the next step would be they'll be giving you some instructions on how to verify your domain ownership via DNS record. So if you have a DNS provider like GoDaddy or other DNS provider, you can select from this little arrow button. They will give you different instructions on what you can do. You can sign in to your, if you have GoDaddy, which some of you might have. So for myself, most of my websites, I use namecheap.com. So you sign into that website and then you can copy this text over here. Click on this button, copy, and then you can sign, go into your domain name provider and paste this in onto your website. Once this piece of code is pasted on your DNS provider, so if you didn't buy your URL directly from Shopify, you were on GoDaddy or Namecheap or other provider, which you can see from this list over here. So likely you'll be copying this piece of text and then you go to your provider's website, sign in, and then you can paste this code there. And once the code has been saved, pasted and saved, you click on verify below. As you can see, there's this gray button over here, verify. So before you paste this code in, you don't verify. If you're not ready, you can say verify later. I'm not going to go into the details of the individual DNS provider. You'll be able to follow the instructions over there. So once it's verified, the next thing, oh yes, these are the other DNS provider on 1&1, or if you have other DNS provider, there's a list here so you can search for it yourself. So once you have verified, then this is going to show up. So on this screenshot over here, there's a settings right on the left hand panel is the menu. So right at the bottom, there is a settings. If you click on settings page, it will show that you are a verified owner. So what's the purpose of verification? The idea is that only you as the Shopify store owner will be able to have direct access to this information of how you communicate your website or your online store's web pages and product pages with Google. If you were not able to paste the code directly, set it up, then what happens is anyone, you, me, anybody in the world can go and submit your website information to Google. And that's why you need ownership verification. The whole purpose of what I've explained earlier is basically to tell Google you are the owner of the Shopify store, you own the URL, you own your store, and you want to submit your information to Google and tell them to index your pages. So when people go onto google.com and search for any products related on your store, they will pull up your product pages. So that's basically what ownership verification is about. Without this process, basically it means that anyone can come into your store and submit some bogus information to Google, and you don't want that. This will show you are verified after you've done after you've done the verification, then it's done. And then the next thing, so if you have other users or you have other people using your Google Search Console, you can also use this page to add other users to give them permission. And if you have Google Analytics and you know how important it is to know how people are navigating themselves on your online store, you can also connect your Google Search Console to your Google Analytics. This is where you can connect them together. Next thing is you need to do is to add a new sitemap. On the left hand side of the Google Search Console, you will be able to submit a sitemap that basically shows what it is about. So if you submit your sitemap, you can add in this information, URL over here. So for your Shopify store, you have your url.com, your Shopify store url.com. And remember to make sure that your store is ready to be unlocked. So most of the time after you have created your Shopify store itself, what happens is your store is locked by a password. That's what is being done to make sure nobody kind of hacks into your store. But once you are ready for everyone to access those pages. You unlock it with a password, says unlock it. When you submit this sitemap here to Google to tell them how are your pages connected to each other, how many pages do you have, then Google will be able to access this information. This is like giving them a map of how your website looks like and how the pages are connected together. If your store is still password protected, then this wouldn't work and you might likely have an error show up. If all goes well, you've unlocked it and then you go here and add in your new sitemap, likely the second part of your URL sitemap is usually sitemap.xml. So this XML file is a file that's automatically generated by Shopify for your store already, so you don't have to generate it yourself. And once it's done, you click it on and you'll be able to click on this submit button over here. Once you submit it, it will show up here as a line. It will tell you which date you submitted and what's the status, if it's green, and how many URLs you have. These URLs should show the number of pages that you have on your website. Let's say you have product pages and all your other pages and it adds up to like 20 and it shows up as 10. It means that some of your pages are maybe locked and then Google is not able to access those pages, so they can't index those pages, meaning that they are not able to pull those pages and show to Google search users. So you want to make sure the number of pages that you have correspond to the number of discovered URLs. So that's a good check for you. Once everything is submitted and then you discover that maybe some of your pages are not discovered by Google yet, you can actually go over here, which is URL inspection over here. You'll be able to type in or copy and paste your URL here and ask Google to individually index those pages. So once those pages are indexed, then you're all good to go. So you just need to wait for Google to process all this information, categorize all those pages that you have submitted to them, and then Google will know whether when someone goes onto Google search or image search for your product, whether it makes sense for them to show your product page to them, whether it's relevant to what a potential shopper is looking for. And to also double check that you know that all the pages on your Shopify store has been indexed, this is a little hack for you. You can go to your browser yourself and type in site colon their Shopify store URL, type in and then tap on enter, and that will show you all the pages that Google knows about your online store. So if you have 20 pages, then you will see 20 URLs pop up on the search results. So this is basically like a little hack to kind of query to Google which are the pages that Google knows about your site. So this is kind of like a double check. This is a good check because you can see specifically which are the pages that are being shown or what are the missing pages. So in the sitemap checker, you can see that if you have 20 pages and 10 show up, you know 10 are missing, but maybe you don't know which are the 10. So here you can actually show you which are the 10 that has been indexed by Google, and then you will be able to reconcile and say, oh, this is this 10. Okay, I have this other 10 other products over here. I know exactly which one it is, and then you can go and submit to the URL. As I mentioned earlier, you can submit them here individually, submit it like on your 10 different URLs. You specifically tell Google, I have this page here, please index it. And that's it. This is how you will set up Google Search Console for your Shopify store, so Google knows all about your product pages or all your content pages, so they can show it to potential shoppers when they are searching for products on search.
Now you know how to set up Google Search Console and how to send over all the information about your Shopify store over to Google Search. What you need to do now is to wait patiently for a couple of days to 1 to 2 weeks to wait for Google to come back to you. Once your website has been registered on Google system, you will be able to find out by going back to Search Console and see what are the pages that has been registered on Google's end. If you need more information on how you can also get your products listed on Google Shopping, you can also check out some of my other videos right here where I show you how you can set up. If you also want to be listed on Google Shopping for free, this is my other video that you need to check out over here. And if you also need other help all about free listings and all to overcome these errors or disapproval problems with Google Merchant Center, this is my other videos right here, so do check them all out. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, tap on the like button And don't forget to hit subscribe and hit on the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. I'll see you. Bye.